Well, my apologies, I screwed up. I had copied all the videos off this memory card to open up some space. And then I forgot to delete them, so this thing, I didn't hear it tell me that it was full. So anyway, it turned off a while ago. I got the rocker cover off, which was a project. So now I want to get a zoom on how to take these pushrod covers off, because this is new to me.
These things go down. And then these keepers come out.
So I don't know if you can see that or not, but just gonna zoom this back out and keep doing that.
Inboard one too. Fun. Keepers are out on the rear cylinder. So now it says to collapse these covers. Let's push it up and pull it down. Maybe I shouldn't have pulled it out the top. I don't know if it matters. So now the bike has to go back on the lifts, because I need to be able to turn the motor and turn the cams. Thunderstorm outside, in case you're wondering. Well, this is probably gonna put a bunch of oil out the side when I straighten the bike up and put it on the jack. So far, this has been pretty painless. Yeah. tedious, yes. But pain free, really, considering how this is all brand new. Alright, I got only one minor screw up so far. Just thrashing those retainers on my exhaust manifold bolts. Nuts. So now I'm going to straighten up the bike, jack back under it, pull the exhaust spark plugs, put it in fourth gear. That cam position right. It's gonna be oil coming out over here, I guess. Spark plugs are out. It's in first gear now. Second, third. It says removing the rocker arms with the valve train loaded can result in bent push rods, etc. Both lifters of the cylinder being serviced must be on the base circle, the lowest position in the can. It's necessary to remove or to rotate the engine. The vehicle on the center stand places the transmission in fifth gear and rotate the rear wheel in a clockwise position is viewed from the right side, so that's a normal drive direction. See figure T-step 7D behind the base circle. Rotate until the piston is top dead center. It's got to be top dead center of the compression stroke, so apparently they're different between the exhaust stroke and the compression stroke. So it's talking about keeping track of this lifter for the intake. So exhaust, intake, intake, exhaust. So this rear lifter is driving the rear rocker arm. This front lifter is driving the front rocker arm, and that's the intake. Oh yeah, there goes all the oil on the floor. Nice. So what it wants me to do is track the rise and fall of that lifter. Seems like it'd be easier to do it on the rocker arm. Compression stroke, top dead center, both valves will be closed. I'm making it. How are you, sweetie? How are you doing, handsome? You're okay, Mickey Man. You're okay, sweetie. Relatively easy to turn with two hands, but I don't know how I'm going to do that and watch what's going on. Mickey, go back inside. No, Mickey, no. Go back inside. Go on. Inside. Good boy. What I used to do was to put a wooden dowel on the top of the piston. It's good for top dead center, but I'm not even sure where my wooden dowel is anymore. Wooden dowel on an old coat hanger, old style suit hanger. Grab the spokes of the wheel, it's kind of tough, but you give yourself another little bigger radius by grabbing the tire itself. That's at the top. And this bike is filthy. Center. You think you'd be able to tell from the cams. just by the way the cams are. So prehistoric here. You can do this. Come in. Well, I was thinking this might feel some play in the rocker arm. I pop that center, but I don't feel anything in there. That's pushing air out the top. The thing is, on the compression stroke, those valves will be closed, so the only way the air is going to come out of that cylinder is through the spark plug hole. Whereas on the top of the exhaust stroke, of course, the exhaust valve is open. So it's not going to have to force air out the spark plug hole. So I just went around again. It seems like should be able to tell compression from the exhaust just by watching. No play at all. I think those lifters are going down. You know, what that movement. Experience really helps. Hopefully that's not going to crush my light with that rocker arm turns. Alright, I'm pretty sure that was the exhaust or the compression stroke top dead center, but I'm going to go around again. Drop it down, and then it's going to come back up, and it's going to stick close. Mm. on its way back down. And I'm watching the rear. So it exhausts, then the exhaust closes, then it intakes. And I don't see that exhaust valve moving at all. The exhaust valve is closed, it's on the intake. Now it's down. So it's down. That means the piston is approximately the bottom following compression stroke. And now it's up. Exhaust valve just closed. The piston is coming back up. Piston's coming up and the exhaust valve is closed. It's got to be a compression stroke. Be easy to work on that. Pistons, yeah. All right. That's the top dead center. The rear cylinder is the top dead center on the compression stroke. Push rod was supposedly unloaded. I can't tell anything by looking in the lifter block. Nothing's loose there. Following the pattern shown in figure B of and B of figure 3-21, alternately loosen each of the four rocker arm support plate bolts just one quarter turn. Continue turning in these increments until loose. Remove the bolts and the washers. So we're going to take those all the way out, but we're going to take them out one quarter turn at a time.
left rear, right front.
Basically, you just want to turn that until it's loose.
It's probably better with a wrench than a socket.
Alright, at this point I'm going to get out the wrench.
This back together is going to be fun. Remove the bolts and washers and remove the support plate assembly. And I don't think I really have to do that. Let's see here. I need to do steps 1 through 11. Oh yeah, I do. Is it going to take the push out of it? I'm running out of room in my cardboard box for holes. or right there. Got myself turned around. Hitting the tank. Right rear, right front is still in. Left rear bolts aren't going to come out with the tank on. Now all those bolts are loose. Only one of them's out. Push rods, tag the push rods as they're removed so they can be installed in their original locations. Also take note to be able to tell top from bottom. So the top. Rear cylinder, or the exhaust valve, rear cylinder.
three at the top, two at the top, one at the top. Exhaust, intake, exhaust. Pushing up this push rod cover, that other one came out through the bottom easy. This one's a little more of a game. Still comes out okay then. So there, rear cylinder is done. Sorry, you missed the rocker box cover. That was an interesting exercise, and the push rod covers. But I guess we'll try again with the video of it on the front. Says to check and make sure you've got the O-rings for the push rod covers and discard them. So there's one, two, remove three O-rings from push rod covers and discard. One at the top, one at the bottom, and one where the middle meets together. So make sure that you get these out of the... Those are different. So that's something else to order. Well, hopefully not order. Pick up at the Harley shop. Turn the video off and take a break. So far so good though. Slow, but so far so good.